Today's Boston Weekly Advertiser.
To business.
With Solaris' blight, be thinking.
Oi, lad. How's it going then?
I am well. And you?
Oh, I can't complain. There was something I've been meaning to tell you.
I met your dad.
It was a long time ago, in London. I was just a boy. Well, didn't meet him really. Just saw him do a fella in at the London Opera House. I was sitting in the balcony with an uncle of mine. Went to have a piss. And when I came back, there's your dad. Dashing as they come, he was. Shirt, jacket, immaculate. My uncle was just slumped there. Looked like he was sleeping, but I knew better, even if I was only a child. Your da locked eyes on me. And I don't think I've ever been so frightened as I was in that instant. It wasn't a fear that he was going to cause me pain. It was this sense that he saw right through me, into my heart, and he would crush it if it had pleased him. But he didn't. He just raised his finger to his lips and gestured for my silence. I complied. And then he was gone.
That must have been in the days before his betrayal was made public. He would have sailed for the colonies not long after. I'm astonished that you were actually there.
You can imagine my surprise when I saw his face. It took me a while to piece it together, but there you have it. Thought you'd like to know.
Thank you. How are you faring?
I'm not bad, not bad. All this reminds me of being back in the old country, fighting for land, fighting for the right to see God my way. Didn't take long before I realized the fight was futile, except aboard a ship bound for the colonies. People over there are so wrapped up in how you perceive the Lord, they forget we're all part of his flock. Stories change, Connor. The way people tell them evolves. It's no different in the Bible, and I believe that's the real root of all the strife back home. But nobody wants to listen to me. If you don't see it their way, you're a heathen. But I feel we're honestly making a difference here. That our presence is felt, if not appreciated by all. And it makes me sleep easy at night, and that's all a man can ask for, really.
I would like to visit your home country someday.
How would you know? You'd turn a head or two in the Emerald Isle, I'll tell you that. Maybe one day I'll muster up the courage, go back, I'll bring you with me. It'd be good for a laugh at any rate.
Ah, Connor! Sit, sit!
How are you, Jacob?
Missing the beer gardens back home, but I'm well.
How did you arrive in the colonies?
Like most other men like me, the army. I was a Hessian for a time. It was a good job while I had it. I only felt it was time for something different once I arrived. Not long after, I am meeting you, so it seems my feeling was useful, no?
Certainly.
I am hoping to send for my family when the time is right. But we are fighting a war of our own, and I will not put them at risk.
Hopefully, things will die down soon.
No rush, Connor. I am in their hearts, and they are in mine. I received a letter from home.
What news?
My son is the strongest boy in our village. Standing tall and proud. My heart grows heavy for them now. And my patience wanes for bringing them across the ocean. I have sent money for passage, war or no war.
We will keep them safe from the fighting when they arrive.
I am having no doubts about this. My worry is now the crossing itself. Many miles overland to a port in France. There they must be purchasing safe passage aboard a ship coming to the colonies. Then they must brave the voyage itself. Many risks.
Your son can lead them. You said yourself he is strong and capable.
My son? Ha! No matter how strong he grows, he will never be as strong as my wife. Wilhelmina is the most able person I have ever met, else I would not have left them. It is more matters of fortune that trouble me. Storms, pirates.
These are things none can control. But I am sure if pirates try and take their ship, Wilhelmina and your boy will make the brigands rue their decision.
Yes. Yes, you're right.
Thank you. Connor.
Commander.
It's good to see you.
You have what you set out for. What will you do with it?
A fair question. But if truth be told, I do not know. Men with far greater minds than mine will build this country's foundations. A task I am simply not equipped for. Have you played bocce before? I'm really growing quite fond of it. I think I'll have a green belt at Mount Vernon when I return.
All that death and sacrifice, and you mean to leave the important tasks to better men while you play games? I might have expected it.
Connor.
Whether you think you are capable or worthy of the task, after the things you have done to ensure this outcome, you should not have the luxury of peace.
Assortment of dry goods, feed, and other staples.
America has no need for
Send
your services,
Send them back to Britain
gentlemen.
In a box! Death to the oppressor!
Cut them down!
If you're hungry, have extra.
No, thank you. Where is everyone?
Gone west. Been a while since they left. Seems some fella from New York was granted the land by Congress.
What?
Seen it happen more and more. Government says they don't take land that's already owned, but...
How could this have happened?
We're on our own now. No more merry English parts and labor. Which means we gotta go at it ourselves. Gotta pay for it too. Selling land is quick and easy, not quite so nasty as taxes. And since some say they're what started the old war, ain't no rush to bring 'em back. Clever men, these new leaders of ours. They know not to push it just yet. Too soon for taxes. Too British.
Thank you.
Be safe.
Calma. need to help me.
You won't lose your leg, that much I can promise you. But it will hurt some for a time longer. Looks worse than it is. Just keep...
Back again? What do you got for me? Blow me or... You've earned the last of these blasted things. Be sure to let me know what you find, eh?
Doctor, you need to help me.
You won't lose your leg, that much I can promise you. But it will hurt some for a time longer. Looks worse than it is. Just keep it clean and you should be fine. Honor, I simply can't get to all these men in reasonable time. I need help. From you, from anyone!
I think I have someone for you. Diana, come with me. I need your help.
Of course. What's the matter?
Dr. White is overwhelmed and needs some extra hands.
I'm no doctor, Connor.
Maybe not. But I have seen you care for people before.
Diana, perfect. I'm told you have a healer's hand. Please see to this young man. Connor, if you could help the two gentlemen out front.
Thanks, Skip. Good of you to help. I should be all right.
Many thanks, Captain.
That's a spot better, sir. Thanks.
Caught a piece of shrapnel in the shoulder. Bad luck. Thank you, Captain.
Caught some burn off a rope. It happens. Thanks, Skipper.
You did well, Connor. But Diana, you impressed me greatly.
Well, thank you, Doctor. I haven't studied the practice or anything.
Maybe not, but your instincts are superb, and you have a healer's touch. If you had the time, I would be grateful for your help on a more regular basis.
Might be Catherine could watch the young ones a few days a week.
And if she can't, we'll find someone who will.
Good day, Connor.
Hello, Dr. White. Diana?
Hello there, Connor.
Diana and I were just having a look over our equipment and facilities. They've seen a great deal of use in the last few days.
So things have turned for the better?
Better than it ever was in Boston. I was missing my apprentice when things first exploded, but now I have Diana. She's better than he was in every respect.
And are you happy, Diana?
I never thought this would be my path, but now that I'm here, I admit it feels right.
One day, Doc, one day, you'll find one, too. She'll come wandering into the village and light up your life. Mark my words, I'm telling you. I have a sense for these things.
Might be, might be. Ahoy, Connor! Look at us. Three bachelors waiting for love, or waiting for a drink, whatever comes first. Drink wins!
Women will be lining up for you, Doc. I'm telling you. Ladies love a healer. It's me that's doomed. Who wants to marry a woodworker, eh? Who? Nobody is who.
Hogwash! You brought the folding chair to the Americas. You're a pioneer, an entrepreneur. Women appreciate a man with vision.
What about you, Connor? How is it a man like you has no wife?
I would not be a good husband. I have not the time to give. One day, perhaps. Old man. Achilles. What is it?
Achilles has passed.
I'm so sorry.
He passed peacefully and with dignity.
A service, then?
Yes. Please prepare something appropriate. I will see the grave is dug. Can you gather everyone?
Anna, if you are reading this, I have failed to say goodbye as I wanted, but the time never seemed appropriate. I leave this land and all its resources to you. I trust you now know this place has become something of great significance. A community to serve as an example of what this would-be nation could become. But the larger and stronger it grows, the more fragile and difficult to defend it becomes. I hope your friends who are birthing this infant country understand this truth. Your unwavering tenacity and honesty have burdened you with responsibility far greater than any one man should bear. But you, if anyone, are capable. You have given an old man hope that all is not lost. And for that, I thank you. I ask that you lay my bones to rest on the hill overlooking the water. There is no other place on this earth I'd rather be. I am grateful to have met you, knowing you will guide this land and these people to a better future. Yours in brotherhood.
Prayer and sermon do not suit this occasion. Achilles was not a man of God. Not my God, at any rate. But he certainly believed in a guiding force. And he is at peace now, and for that we can be grateful. We lay him to rest here, atop the bluff where he made his honorable and dignified life, so he can remain that comforting presence, the old man on the hill, that we have all grown to depend on. You all had your own relationships with him, your own moments, and I implore you to return here when the time is right for you and share those stories with the waves and the trees. Achilles, you will be missed, but never forgotten. Go safely, old man, safely to where your soul need rest.
I will make you proud, old man. I never properly said goodbye to you. I was not ready, so here I am. The weight of my responsibilities never seems to diminish. There is always something else that needs fighting for. This is something you never warned me of. Maybe because you thought I would have been deterred. You would have been wrong, but I know you were not accustomed to that. Life carries on here. The people seem happy.
They are certainly safe, at least for now. One of my brotherhood asked me something I have been struggling with. What happens if, when we win? When we stop the Templars? It is a question I certainly do not know the answer to. Perhaps you did not either. I miss you, as I miss my mother. I hope all is well with you, wherever you are. Goodbye, old man. Until it comes time for me to join you, then I will bother you once again.
Day, Connor. How are you faring?
I will honor him in time. I just hope that what I do is enough.
If anybody is capable of honoring a man the likes of Achilles, it's you, Connor.
How is your church?
It's everything I could have wanted and more. The people here are hardworking and appreciative of my services. They contribute more than most I've seen. I understand our God is not for you. But the community is strong when we gather within these walls. That much you should see.
I will pass through one of these days. Joseph Palmer retired to Jamaica. Somewhere around this castle, Faulkner said the scroll would likely have ended up in Lord Lewis Hutchinson's private museum. This place has seen much evil. Hutchinson's personal museum. Kid's scroll must be here somewhere. The shot must have come from the balcony. The killer must have chased his prey, but through where? The mechanism of the mask is broken. I do not understand how anyone could live here. Small wonder Hutchinson went mad. This place feels mad. There must be some clues around that can help me with this. The other clocks might tell me something. Thank you. close to a tree kissed by fire.
What do you make of it?
They all appear to be parts of the same piece of leather. It lies under the eagle's bed, near the wolf's abode, close to a tree kissed by fire, and abreast the rock that does not fit, and a route to an island. The symbols remain elusive.
That's Oak Island. I've sailed past it 50 times. A forgettable isle, to say the least.
The location seems to be the easy part.
Aye. And we'll be waiting for you the moment you want to get after it.
You actually found something?
I'm a little on edge, Captain. The prospect of Captain Kidd's treasure and the mysteries that lie with it have me a trifle spooked.
Stay your anxiety. It is likely only treasure.
I thought the same thing, but considering what the man went through to hide it, I'm not so sure. All those scrolls lead us to the belly of this remote island. Awful out of the way, Captain. What was Kidd hiding, for cripe's sake?
I do not know, but I am intrigued to find out.
Remember what was written. Close to a tree kissed by fire, near the wolf's abode, under the eagle's bed and the rock that does not fit. Whatever that means. Do you think there might be landmarks?
Possibly. Got it. Done. There. Got it. That is it.
There. That is it. Got it. I know where it is.
How in the... You figured it out. Well, that's why you're the captain.
That's a bloody big piece of stone. Any ideas?
Perhaps some gunpowder would move it.
A nice big explosion, eh? Might do the job. We'll do well to scare away any more blasted wolves, that's for certain. That ought to be enough.
This is what Captain Kidd suffered over for so long. Astonishing.
Lost you there for a moment, Captain. Are you all right?
Yes. I think so.
What happened down there? What did you find? That's it? A single gold coin? There was nothing else? Was the cash pilfered already? Ah!
What the devil?
I do not know how it works, but I now understand why Kidd valued it so.
That's a curious little piece, isn't it? Well, I've worked my incredible and bottomless magic, and that little thing is, in fact, of first civilization origin. It seems they use them as personal shields. It gives off a rather powerful electromagnetic field, explains its aversion to metal, also explains why Kid's legend tells of him being invincible. Having that trinket in your pocket would easily bend a musket ball's trajectory. Nifty little thing, really. Anyway, just thought you want to know. Please do carry on.